Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to break down everything you have to know about Coinbase versus Coinbase Pro. Picking the right platform is crucial because if you pick the wrong one, you could end up destroying your profitability and just flushing money down the toilet. Or even if you pick the right platform, but then just buy your crypto the wrong way, like with a credit card, Coinbase will slap you with some insane fees. So I'm gonna break this down into four sections. Their fees, features, mobile apps, and their ease of use. This will encapsulate basically your entire experience with either platform and tell you everything you need to know about Coinbase versus Coinbase Pro. And remember that if you enjoy this video too, please like and leave a comment down below for the YouTube algorithm. All right, so first, the fees. I'm not gonna lie, the fee structures of Coinbase and Coinbase Pro are both pretty complex, so I'm gonna break this down as simply as I possibly can. First, let's take a look at the original Coinbase. So with Coinbase, there are three fees that you always need to keep in mind, and those are the spread fee, the flat fee, and the variable fee. The spread fee is always about 0.5% of your transaction, and then Coinbase will also come up with a variable fee and a flat fee. Whichever is higher, the flat fee or the variable fee, you will have to pay. The flat fee breaks up into four tiers based on the size of your transaction. If your transaction is less than $10, then you will pay a $1 fee. $10 to $25 and you'll pay $1.50. $25 to $50 and you will pay $2. And if your total transaction is between $50 and $200, then you will have to pay a $3 flat fee. But remember, you will only pay these fees if it is higher than the variable fee. Now, your variable fee depends on your location and how you purchase the crypto. For the United States, you're going to be charged 1.49% if you buy the crypto using money from your bank account or from your Coinbase wallet. And you will be charged 3.99% if you make a purchase using your debit card. And this is all on top of the 0.5% spread fee I mentioned earlier. So as a quick example, let's say you buy $100 of Bitcoin using money from your bank account. You would get charged the 0.5% spread fee, and then your flat fee would be $3, and the variable fee would be 1.49%, which is $1.49. But since the flat fee of $3 is higher than that, you're gonna have to pay the flat fee. This means you would end up paying about $3.50 on a $100 transaction, which is 3.5%, which is terrible. Okay, so that was a quick look at the immense fee structure that Coinbase has. Now let's compare that to Coinbase Pro. Now, Coinbase Pro has quite a bit of a better fee structure, in my opinion. I actually used to use them a long time ago when they were still called GDAX. So with Coinbase Pro, your fees are entirely variable and are based upon how much money you've transacted with over the last 30 days. The less you've traded, the more you'll pay, and the more you've traded, the less you'll pay. Okay, so by far, most people will fit into the first three pricing tiers. If you don't, good for you. So the first tier is that your trades over the last 30 days add up to a total less than $10,000. In this tier, you would pay a 0.5% maker fee and a 0.5% taker fee. In the second tier, the price drops slightly, but the maker and taker fee are still equal. However, as we move up further, the maker fee drops below the taker fee. Now, if you don't know what this means, I'm gonna break it down really quick. You are considered a taker and will be charged a taker fee if your order gets filled immediately. Meaning if you buy or sell using a market order, then your order will get filled immediately and you are essentially taking from the market. However, if you make a limit order and your order does not fill immediately, then you're considered a market maker. This is because you're adding liquidity to the platform by just allowing your money to sit there, waiting for a taker to swoop in and fill your order. Market makers are valuable to the platform because of this added liquidity, so the fees are lower. Now, this means that if you're trading a lot of crypto, then you might want to place limit orders as opposed to market orders. Okay, so that was an overview of the fees of Coinbase versus Coinbase Pro. Now let's take a look at the features. First of all, Coinbase is geared towards beginners and really provides a good amount of value for its high prices. There's a news feed on Coinbase that constantly feeds you new information. You can set alerts for certain cryptos you're interested in, and they will even pay you to watch some educational videos on their mobile app. Coinbase Pro is much more of a traditional basic trading platform and does not have any of this. However, a huge plus with Coinbase Pro is that you can set a variety of orders, meaning you can make limit orders and stop loss orders, which you can't do on Coinbase. Coinbase Pro also has a much more in-depth interface that has a lot of deep information that you just can't get on Coinbase. And now both platforms have two-factor authentication for security, and they are both FDIC insured up to $250,000. Okay, now let's look deeper into the mobile apps of Coinbase and Coinbase Pro, and we'll talk a little bit about their ease of use. But first, I want to mention really quickly that I personally have money in both Coinbase and Coinbase Pro, but I also use another service called BlockFi. I like to keep some crypto in BlockFi along with Coinbase and Coinbase Pro because BlockFi pays you interest, 5% per year on Bitcoin and 8% per year on USDC. So if you want to earn some interest on your crypto like I do, then click the link in the description below or my pinned comment, sign up for BlockFi, deposit $100, and we will each get between $10 and $250 of free Bitcoin. So if you sign up with my link, you will make my day and you will also make a lot more money from your crypto. And if you just want Coinbase, there is a link down for that as well, and we will each get some free Bitcoin from that too. Okay, so the mobile apps of Coinbase and Coinbase Pro are both great in my opinion, but they're great in very different ways and for different people. The original Coinbase is much better for beginners and it shows information similar to how Robinhood shows information for stocks. The charts are just simple line graphs that aren't very useful, but they are appealing to the eye. And if you scroll down, you will get a summary and some key metrics like market cap and typical hold time. Now with Coinbase Pro, you don't get the key metrics or the summary, but you do get a much better charting tool. The charts in Coinbase Pro are candlestick charts that really show a lot more detail about the actual price action. And if you swipe to the right, you can see a live depth chart, which basically shows how many buy orders are sitting in the market and how many sell orders are there as well. It's kind of like watching a Mortal Kombat fight between the bulls and the bears. And if you swipe over again, you will see the same thing, except it displays more per price point data. As you can tell by the information they share with you in the app and just from traveling around the app, Coinbase Pro is more made for experienced investors, whereas Coinbase is just for someone trying to dip their toes into Bitcoin or Ethereum or whatever it is. However, if you can get used to the Coinbase Pro app and start working with it confidently, then you will save a lot of money in fees. Personally, I use Coinbase Pro along with BlockFi for my Bitcoin and Ethereum, but I do have some altcoins in Coinbase. But by far, the majority of what I do is Coinbase Pro and BlockFi. Okay, so I'm gonna recap everything I laid out in this video so that you can make your final decision on Coinbase versus Coinbase Pro. So when you buy crypto on the regular Coinbase, you will have to pay 0.5% spread fee, and then you will also pay either a flat fee or a variable fee. Whichever one is higher is the one you're gonna pay. Generally, if you aren't buying very much, you're gonna have to pay the flat fee, but if you're making a big purchase, then the variable fee is what you're gonna have to pay. On the other hand, Coinbase Pro charges a maker-taker fee, which will be about 0.5% for most people. Overall, Coinbase Pro is cheaper and has the better fee structure. However, when it comes to features, they both have their strengths. While Coinbase Pro is more of a data-only trading platform, Coinbase has a lot of cool features. With Coinbase, you get a news feed that's a constant supply of information. You can set alerts for the cryptos that you're watching, and you can even watch educational videos, and they will pay you for watching them. But while Coinbase Pro lacks these features, you can set limit orders, which is crucial, really. And their apps are both great, but for very different reasons. So depending on your experience level and confidence level, Coinbase Pro is going to be better if you have more experience. Coinbase is going to be better for the newbie. Okay, so the best platform for you depends on what your personal priorities are. If you need to think about what is important to you, then take some time to do that and then come back to this video, rewind it and rewatch it so you can come to your conclusion on Coinbase versus Coinbase Pro. And remember, if you choose Coinbase, then click the link in the description below and we will each get some free Bitcoin when you sign up, Or if you also want interest on your crypto, then click the BlockFi link and we'll get some crypto there too. Hopefully you enjoyed this, and if you did, then leave a like and leave a comment down below letting me know which one you ended up choosing. All right, thank you for watching, and I'll see you again next time.